We just solved this rational equation by eliminating the denominators by multiplying each fraction by the least common denominator. So now we'll take a look at an alternative method of solving this by a method called building fractions. And this method will remind you of how we add and subtract rational expressions. We're first going to build each fraction so that they have the same denominator or a common denominator. Then we're going to simplify the numerators. Then we'll combine the numerators. And then since denominators are the same, the numerators must be equal to each other. So we'll set the numerators equal to each other and solve, and then we'll check our solutions. The first step here is to make sure all the denominators are in factored form. X squared plus 3x minus 18 can be factored, but factor into two binomial factors. Factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 18 that add to positive 3 are positive 6 and negative 3. Notice these two factors would be the least common denominator. So now we're going to build these fractions so they have the same denominator. So for the first fraction of the quantity x minus 3 over the quantity x plus 6, notice how the denominator is missing a factor of x minus 3. So we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by x minus 3, which is the same as multiplying by 1, plus for the second fraction, we have the quantity x minus 2 over the quantity x minus 3. Notice how this fraction is missing the factor of x plus 6. So we'll multiply this fraction by x plus 6 over x plus 6. Then the fraction on the right already contains our common denominator, so we'll leave it the same. Notice now all the fractions have the same denominator. Now we're going to simplify the numerators, meaning we'll find this product and this product. So for this first fraction, we'll have four products in the numerator. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll have x squared minus 3x minus 3x, that's minus 6x, and then negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9, so we have plus 9, plus this fraction has the same factors in the denominator, and again we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, 4. So x times x is x squared, x times 6 is 6x, then negative 2 times x is negative 2x. 6x plus negative 2x is positive 4x. And we have negative 2 times 6, that's negative 12, or minus 12, equals x squared all over the quantity x plus 6 times the quantity x minus 3. Now we'll go ahead and add these two fractions here because we have a common denominator. So we'll have x squared plus x squared, that's 2x squared. Negative 6 plus 4x, that's minus 2x. 9 plus negative 12 would be negative 3, or minus 3. And this is still equal to x squared all over the quantity x plus 6 times the quantity x minus 3. Now here, since these are equal and the denominators are the same, the numerators must equal each other. So now we're going to solve the equation 2x squared minus 2x minus 3 equals x squared. Again, because the denominators are already the same, if we want these to be equal, then the numerators must be equal. So we'll solve the equation 2x squared minus 2x minus 3 equals x squared. We'll go ahead and set this equal to 0 and see if we can factor it. So we'll subtract x squared on both sides. Notice how we have 0 on the right now. So we have x squared minus 2x minus 3. Looks like this will factor. The factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 3 that add to negative 2 are negative 3 and positive 1. So the solutions to this will be the values of x that make each of these factors equal to 0. So x equals 3 or x equals negative 1. But remember, when solving a rational equation, it is important that we check our solutions. And the main thing we're checking for is that we don't have division by 0. we go back up to this original equation here, notice if x is equal to 3, we have division by 0 in the second fraction, which means x equals 3 cannot be one of our solutions. Notice when x is negative 1, none of the denominators would be 0. Therefore, the only solution that we have is x equals negative 1. So solving this equation like this is an alternative to multiplying each fraction by the LCD to eliminate the denominators from the very first step. And if you're comfortable with adding and subtracting rational expressions, you may prefer this method. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.